Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's the event you've all been waiting for. In this corner, coming in at a 507 grams, the old-timer. Coming out of retirement for this fight, the 2017 champion of the world, the XT2!
That 24-megapixel sensor looks a little dated, Howard.
I don't know, Bob. It could be enough to hang in there with the best of them. 26 megapixels ain't too far off, which brings me to... In this corner, the rookie and true heavyweight coming in at a whopping 607 grams. He's looking to become the 2020 APS-C champion of the world, the Fujifilm X-T4! Can this youngster take out the old-timer, Bob?
This is gonna be a heck of a matchup.
And here we go. Oh, the X-T4 looking quite stable and balanced with his IBIS. And look at this, the X-T4 throws a big left hook. I can't believe what I'm seeing here.
What a fully articulating slap to the face.
Now wait, look at this, Bob. The X-T2 is so light and agile, he's running circles around the youngster.
Oh my God.
Oh, a vertical screen uppercut. The big boy goes down. A one, a two,
a three. Yeah, a champion of the world. Hey guys. Okay, upgrading from the X-T2 directly to the X-T4. On paper, it's really no contest, right? You should upgrade. The X-T4 has a brand new battery, which is fantastic. It has a fully articulating screen. It has image stabilization built in. This camera, the X-T4, has much more powerful autofocus. You can follow a face in full zone. It has 4K60 if you're a video shooter. Totally easy upgrade. The X-T2 has no touchscreen whatsoever. It lacks some of the film simulations. I was about to say stimulation again. It lacks some of the film simulations. For example, Eterna and Bleach Bypass, which are new ones in the X-T4. Sure, it shoots 4K30, but there's no face detection in that mode. The X-T4 has face detection that will follow you everywhere. The battery's tiny, so you need about 3 to 5 batteries for a full day of travel. Totally sucks, right? Or does it? You see, all of these things depend. If you talk to loyal X-T2 owners, they don't care about this heavyweight champion that's out. You know, it depends. What kind of shooter are you? Are you mostly a still shooter? Are you taking photographs for yourself? Is really anyone going to notice the difference between the two sensors? Probably not. If you're a casual shooter, a competent street photographer, maybe you zone focus, you shoot everything at F8. You don't even look at the screen or the EVF when you shoot. If you like a smaller and lighter camera, I can't believe I'm saying that about the X-T2 being an X-T20 owner, but the X-T2 is lighter and easier to carry. You shoot from the hip maybe, so you like this flip screen that comes up. X-T2 owners have gotten so used to carrying extra batteries, turning the camera off when not in use. So switching, probably not. But upgrading to the X-T4 may be in your cards. There are 3 areas where I would welcome an upgrade, and this might be you. The first one, the EVF, is lovely. It shares the same EVF that's in the X-T3, so if you have an X-T3 or have held one, it's the same as that, and it's a joy to shoot. You know, no joke, after using the X-T4 for the last few weeks, I actually picked up what I thought was the X-T20 because I looked in the viewfinder and I was like, that's kind of small in there. And it turns out it was the X-T2. That's how much nicer the EVF is on here. 2, the fact that it's a more powerful video camera is very, very cool. So some of you may want that. It's got a dedicated movie switch, which allows you to save your settings on the camera when you're switched to video. I loved having the screen for video. I don't prefer the screen for photography at all, but for video, to do updates with the family, really, really welcoming. Now, by the way, if you don't have that, I did a video on this cheap little mirror thingy. You know, you can actually put that on your X-T2 if you need to record yourself. But the second reason to upgrade is if you're very video-centric and you need that stabilization and the quick recording features. Third, the third thing I loved about using the camera was the IBIS. In my last video, when I shot the New York City skyline, I was getting up to about a half second handheld without needing a tripod. And what was great about that is my ISOs were really low, 200, 160, 400, in really dark conditions. So as a photographer, IBIS is very useful. For video, I have stabilized lenses, but for photography, I loved not, I actually brought a tripod and didn't use it and got to shoot handheld. So that IBIS performance for photography, those of you that like low light or need to shoot without a tripod, fantastic. Now I will say it's not crazy, you know, you won't be doing slowing down water and shooting things, you know, for 10 seconds or 5 seconds. I got as low as half a second or a second of stability handheld. Okay, and the reason that I wouldn't upgrade, or my biggest disappointments with the camera, really the biggest one, the biggest disappointment, is the size. Now be aware that I use Fujifilm for its size. I love small pocketable cameras for travel and for street. I don't want any, that's why I bought Fujifilm, was for its size. But maybe this could be your A camera, not your B camera, your portrait camera, your jobs camera. But price-wise, now we're entering in Sony a7 III territory, the same ballpark. And that's a full frame, has better low light performance, and way better autofocus. So some of you may have to pick between a full frame camera and the price of this guy is sort of getting a little high for that. You could get the Fujifilm X-T2 for a lot lower used. Now, another hangup I had with the Fujifilm X-T4 is it was great that you had presets for film simulations and your aperture and shutter. But you know, I couldn't save my frame rate. Like I couldn't have one setting that was 4K and the other one that was 1080p. So although it was kind of auto to have your film simulation and your looks, it didn't save my frame rate. So sometimes I wanted to shoot 1080p, I'd have to switch that. All right, so my recommendation is if you're mostly into photography and you like street photography and you like a smaller camera hanging around your neck, then the X-T2 is fantastic. You don't need to upgrade if you know how to, you know, work this camera. The X-T4 is not gonna give you much more photo-wise. However, if you need better autofocus, if you like the tracking, if you need the flip-out screen for video, if you kinda are sick about carrying 3-4 batteries, then the X-T4 is a fantastic upgrade. All right, so who is the APS-C champion of the world? Is it the X-T4 or the X-T2? Well, you know what? It totally depends on you. And I know you hate that answer. I can't tell you what to buy. But for me, mostly photography, mostly using Fujifilm for smaller, awesome, stealthy street and travel camera, I would pick the X-T2 for photo features, great sensor, fantastic. Just make sure you don't look through the EVF of the X-T4 because it's just beautiful. Now, those of you that are leaning towards doing more video, you like the stabilization, maybe you need the stabilization to sort of shoot in lower light, keep your ISOs down, better battery, you don't mind a big, maybe you have large hands. The X-T4 is an amazing camera and had a really great time shooting with it. Just be aware that you really have to like this articulating screen because I didn't like this screen sticking out when I was shooting from the hip. It would be cool if it can flip around, you know, a little bit more and, you know, be a little bit stealthier. I do like that it protects the camera. So if you're putting it in a bag, you can switch this off here. The only thing that happens sometimes is you're gonna look at the LCD and you realize that you have it on protection mode. And so I always have to flip the screen around a lot. That doesn't happen with the X-T2. But you know what? The answer may not be the X-T2 for some of you. It may not be the X-T4. You know, just like Goldilocks said. I'll see you guys next time.